I woke up early this morning with a very strong sense that God wants me to lead worship online and that it's for our nation. So many of you are still asleep. Maybe you're watching this later. Believe me, in my flesh, I do not like getting up early. But I just had such a strong sense that this is something that God wants to do. So I'm here, and whoever is online and ready to worship, praise, pray with me, thank you so much. I really appreciate it. I believe that this is a significant day, significant week for some reason in our nation, and we need to just intercede. And one of the best ways to do that is to thank God, to praise Him, to worship Him, and to speak life over our nation, to prophetically declare that this nation belongs to God. So I put a few songs together this morning. My voice and my body are still waking up, but we're going to go for it. So thank you for joining me this morning. I'm going to try my best to be sound guy, video guy, and worship leader. And yeah, so let's just pray. Lord Jesus, I thank you that we get to worship you in this way this morning. Lord, we want to just come to you and ask that you will bless our nation, that you will heal our nation. I pray that each and every person online right now will just experience such a strong presence of your Holy Spirit. And Holy Spirit, I pray that you will lead this session. I pray that everything will go well and that you will reach everyone that needs to be reached, and that this will create a sound over the nation, even in this way. And I thank you for everyone praying for our nation. I thank you for every marriage, every family that is dedicated to you. And I pray that you'll bless them and strengthen them in this time. Lord, I pray that you will bless us in this time, that you will lead us, and that you will show me what we need to focus on in our prayers, what we need to focus on as we praise and worship you. I pray that you help me. I pray that you lead everyone that's listening, and that you bless us in this time, in Jesus' name. All right, let's do this. I'm going to try a few things new here, so I hope it all works. Here we go.
I was buried beneath my shame. Who could carry the kind of weight? It was my tomb till I met you. I was breathing but not alive. All my failures I tried to hide. It was my turn till I met you.
You call my
chains break at the weight of your glory. I needed rescue, my sin was heavy. Chains break at the weight of your glory. I needed shelter, I was an orphan. Now you call me a citizen of heaven. When I was broken, you were my healing. Now your love is the air that I'm breathing. I have a future, my eyes are open. 'Cause when you call my name, I ran out of that grave, out of the darkness, into your glorious day. You call my name, and I ran out of that grave, out of the darkness, into your glorious day.
Yes, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father God. We love you, Lord. We worship you. We worship you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Nothing can stand it.
The battle belongs to you, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Ack in my heist on the Eredin.
Woo!
Sy lig het kom skyn op my lewe. So ek sing, ek in my huis sal die Here dien. Ek in my huis sal die Here dien. Toe die dag dat ons vir Jesus op die wolke sien. Ja, sing saam, ek in my huis sal vir niks terugstaan. Ek in my huis sal ons nooit kan skaan.
Serve the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Here's the line of Judah.
We can feel your boldness in our veins. Adopted as a child of a king that's never swayed. We can feel the power of your name rising through the chaos and drowning all our shame. The roar of the Lion of Judah is our battle cry. Our hearts will not cower. Your power is where our strength abides. Promises don't change, amen. Even though our flesh may fail, your glory stays the same. We know that
Done. Thank you, Lord. Good morning. Good morning. If you just join us, and you're wondering why I'm live this early in the morning, it's because I was woken early by God, and I just felt such a strong unction to worship, to praise, to thank God, and to speak life over our nation. I feel this is a very significant week in our nation, spiritually speaking, and I just want to call on all the worshipers and all the prayer warriors to stand with me in agreement that this nation belongs to God, that it's a nation of people of God, and let's just declare life, let's declare breakthrough, let's declare beauty, let's declare wholeness, let's declare healing over this nation as we sing these songs today. I really believe that He is the one who reigns, He is the one in charge. And in this morning, we just worship Him. We come together and we worship Him. We thank Him. Psalm 100 says that we enter His gates with thanksgiving and His courts with praise. So let's thank Him. Thank you, Jesus. We worship You. We praise You. We honor You. And if we are in His presence, anything is possible. Amen. So whatever you are facing, I want you to take a chance this morning. Take your eyes off of your own problems. Focus in on Jesus and focus in on our nation. I know from experience when we are able to just for a moment take our eyes off of our own problems and we focus on what God is busy with, what God is doing. We focus on something bigger than ourselves. It is amazing what happens in our own lives as well. How God comes and supernaturally brings healing, brings breakthrough. So we're going to sing this next song and just declare that He is the one who reigns above it all. Amen. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
You reign above it all. The reign of darkness now has ended. In the kingdom of light. In the kingdom of light. Forever under Your dominion. You're the King of my life. You're the King of my life.
You reign above it all.
You reign above it all. You reign above it all.
Amen.
Oh,
On the cross the work was finished. On the cross the work was finished. God, you poured out your life just to give us new life. Now from the lips of the forgiven, hear an anthem arise, 'cause Jesus, you're alive. Oh, you reign above it all. You reign above it all. Over the universe, over the universe, and over every heart, there is no higher name. Jesus, Jesus, you reign above it all. Let all that he reigns. You send the darkness running out of an empty grave. Now seated alone in glory, enthroned on the highest praise. You send the darkness running out of an empty grave. Now seated alone in glory, enthroned on the highest praise. You send the darkness running out of an empty grave. Now seated alone in glory, enthroned on the highest praise. You send the darkness running out of an empty grave. Now seated alone in glory, enthroned on the highest praise. You send the darkness running. Declare that he reigns above it all, in every area of your life, in every area of this nation. We declare and decree that he is king, he is the one who reigns. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Who else? else answers when we pray.
Who else answers when I pray? Who else is with me day by day? None can recreate your amazing grace. None can fabricate the love that sent me free. There's no other God to die to save my soul.
There's no other God.
There's no other God who rose to give me hope. Others try to claim your holy name, but all have tried in vain. You are Lord of all, the living God who reigns.
Declare it, He reigns.
Woo! Who else takes my shame away?
Who else has overcome the grave? Can recreate.
None can recreate
your amazing grace.
Your amazing grace. And none can fabricate the love that set me free. There's no other God who died to save my soul.
There's no other God. Come on.
There's no other God who rose to give me hope. From the valleys to your throne, and in heaven to below, every knee will bow and know that you are God.
He's God. Come on.
So let your name be raised to the highest of all places. Be enthroned without praise, oh God. There's no other God who rose to give me hope.
Others try.
Others try to claim your holy name, but all have tried in vain. You are Lord of all, the living God who reigns. There's no other God who died to save my soul.
Yes.
There's no other God who rose to give me hope.
He gives you hope.
And we declare, Lord, have your way. Have your way, Jesus.
Lord, in your kind and gentle way.
In your kind and gentle way.
You let me struggle on my own.
You let me struggle on my own.
But in your mercy, you still stay.
But in your mercy, you still stay.
Your love cannot leave.
Your love cannot leave me.
You let me try, you let me fail.
You let me try, you let me fail, you let me find the end of myself.
Lord, have your way.
Lord, have your way.
Lord, have.
Lord, have your way. I will listen when you speak, I will go where you lead, I surrender. Lord, have your way. heaven's king. My heart can still feel so afraid, but I have found that where I'm weak is where you meet me in your strength. You let me try. You let me try. Jesus in the Garden of Gethsemane. My heart will sing like your firstborn son. Not my will, but yours be done. My heart will sing like your firstborn son. Not my will, but yours. Sing it with me, come on. My heart.
Contain.
humble hearts we bow and pray. We strain to hear the distant thunder as you say, let it rain, let it rain, let it rain. Let's praise Him for the rain. Oh.
Stand in agreement with me this morning. If you just tune in, we're praying for our nation. We are the gatekeepers the watchman on the wall for our nation. God put us here for a reason. When we pray as sons and daughters of the living God, things change. There's power in prayer. And greater is He that's in us than he that's in the world. The enemy has plans, but God has greater plans. Amen? I want to encourage you this morning to know that if you are a born-again, Holy Spirit-filled, Jesus-following believer, that you are a victor, not a victim. And God is looking at you and He's smiling because He sees a son, He sees a daughter that loves Him. And He sees a heart, a mind, and a spirit that's ready to serve Him in this nation. So I want to encourage you to take what God has given you, even though you may think it's not much. You remember what He did with the 5 loaves and 2 fish. He takes what we have and what He's given us, and He multiplies it in a way that no one will believe, so that all the glory can go to Him. If every Christian in this nation would stand up, be counted in the spiritual realm, stand firm, put on the armor of God, know that the weapons we have in God are mighty to change situations, you will see a nation turn to God. So I want to encourage you, let's stand together in unity, over denominational boundaries, over racial boundaries, over class boundaries. Let's stand united. In John 17, Jesus prays a passionate prayer to the Father about His disciples and the disciples that were to follow. And He pleads with the Father that they will be one, that we, the disciples, will be one as He and the Father are one. Imagine that intimacy in the body of Christ. That's Jesus' heart for us, is to be one, is to be united as He and the Father are united. And you know why? Because twice He says that if they are one, the world will know that You sent Me. He says that to the Father. In other words, our biggest evangelical tool is unity in the body of Christ. When the world looks at the church and sees unity, they will go, wow, Jesus must be real. It must be true that He came to seek and save the lost. But if they look at a church that's divided, fighting, and there's no unity, they won't believe that there's a Jesus. Let's change that. Amen? Let's change that. Let's be part of the solution, not part of the problem. I wrote the song and I sang it with 2 of my brothers in Christ, Luis Obala and Neville D. And I'd love for you to sing it with me this morning as we just declare it's time over our nation. Here we go.
Holy calls are going out. It's a saintly shout. It's time to join our hands. It's time to heal our land. Let's sing in one accord. It's time to love. To heal our land, let's sing it one.
voice, come on.
We are more than conquerors, worldly overcomers. We are free and forgiven, citizens of heaven.
Believe it.
We are more than conquerors, worldly overcomers. We are free and forgiven, citizens of heaven. It's time to join our hands. It's time to make a stand. Let every tribe and tongue unite and be as one. Let's love again. Oh. Let's sing in one accord that we will serve the Lord. Oh yes, we will serve.
Let's declare that today. We will serve the Lord. Amen. The King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, the one who runs this country. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for joining me this morning. If you just joined us, the reason I'm here this morning is I really felt God wake me up very early and say, we need to worship. We need to stand in the gap. We need to intercede. We need to speak life and call the God reigns in this nation. And it takes a humble heart for us to do that, to just bring our nation before God and pray. We can't just assume and accept that everything will be okay when we have been called as watchmen on the wall, when we've been called as ambassadors of Christ in this world. We have been given authority as His children, and we can use it in partnership with Him to change the atmosphere in this nation. From the very personal things that we each face to the national things that are not the way it should be. And this morning we just declare and decree in the name of Jesus Christ that this nation belongs to God. Amen. So I want to sing this last song that I wrote recently, and I want you to sing it with me. The chorus says, our nation belongs to God, and Jesus is our King. Holy Spirit will lead us home because our God is on the throne. You may not know all the other words, but you can sing along and afterwards maybe go get the video on YouTube and play it out loud, share it with everybody, and let's make this song our anthem for South Africa. This is really something straight from God, a song that was just birthed in the Spirit, and it's not about me, it's not about what I want, it's not about the fact that I wrote it, it's just a song that's for our nation. And I pray this morning that it'll bless you and encourage you, and that it'll really just bring a blanket of blessing and protection over our nation. So thank you for joining me this morning. Please keep praying for our nation, interceding, pray for our leaders, pray that people will turn to Jesus, people that are in authority, that may be linked to other beliefs and have other agendas, that everyone whose heart is made of stone will get a heart of flesh, that everyone who has rebelled against God, rebelled against Jesus, will have an encounter with the living God and their lives will change, and that we will see a massive shift in our nation in this week and the months to come. Amen. We come against illness, we come against sickness, we come against this virus, come against everything that's bringing us down, and we just declare and decree in the name of Jesus that there's life, there's healing, there's power, there's authority, there is just abundant life. That's what Jesus came to give us. Amen. But we need to submit, humbly submit to His will. We need to declare that He is King. It's not, the kingdom of God is not a democracy, it is a kingdom. He is the King over His domain. And we need to come humbly before Him, knowing that we are sons and daughters, knowing that we can partner with Him and see a shift. Amen. All right. Thank you so much for joining me in prayer this morning. I really appreciate you guys. And we're going to end off with this song, Our Nation. Let's just declare it over this country of ours. And if you're tuning in from another country, obviously more than welcome to declare it over your nation as well. Amen.
We are done watching our home slip away. Corruption and crime and moral decay. We will model the truth, the life, the way. We declare and decree that our land is free from fear and from hate and from curses decreed. We're united in Christ, we agree. Our nation belongs to God, and Jesus is our King, and Jesus. It's all through, it's our sword, our shield and our guide. The army of God is winning the fight. The army of God is winning the fight. Cause our King is the conqueror, the Father of lights. He is holy, He's worthy, He's right. And our nation belongs to God, come on. Our nation
nation. We declare and decree that our nation is free under the kingdom of God in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Thank you so much for joining us this morning. Thank you for praying with me. Thank you for standing in the gap for our nation. Please keep doing so. And remember, if you want to change the world, go home and love your family. Let's start by praying for our marriages, praying for our children, praying for our homes. And I want to make a specific call on the men of God to stand up and be counted as a man of God, to choose Jesus first in your life, to lay down everything else that's not of Him, that's not who you really are, to discover your full and true identity in Christ and live from that place. Because then you will love your wife well, you will love your children well, you will move your community towards a better place, you will move your workplace to a better place. Men of God, Let's rise up and be the men that God has called us to be. Let's be the fathers that God has called us to be. That's what's going to change a nation. That's what's going to change a nation. Amen? Amen. Thank you so much for joining me this morning. And for all you early risers, this was definitely something new, something unexpected for me as well. But I've learned that when God speaks, I must be obedient and know that He is doing something far greater than I can ever imagine. So please share this, if you will, with other people. And let's pray for our nation in this week. Amen. God loves you so much. He's got a beautiful plan for your life. And He's calling you into more of Him. In Jesus' name. All right. Father God, I just thank you so much for every person that tuned in this morning that's been part of this. I pray that you bless each and every man, each and every woman, each and every child, each and every marriage and family, and that you will cover them, Lord Jesus, with your armor of the armor of God, that you will surround them with the angels you've put over them, that you will cover them with the blood of Jesus, and that they will know that they know who they are in you, and that they will walk as children of God, sons of God, daughters of God, knowing who they are, knowing the fullness of what you've done on the cross, and because of that, that we can walk tall and confident as children of God in this world, knowing that greater is He that's in us than he that's in the world. Thank you, Jesus, that we can walk with the knowledge that we are your children and that this nation belongs to you. I pray that you will help every one of us to have deeper encounters with you in our quiet time, that you will open up the scriptures to us, Holy Spirit, and that we will live from the truth of what that brings, the fullness of what that brings. I pray that in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen and amen. God bless you guys. Have a wonderful rest of your day. And I think I'll see you on Friday on Dr. Arthur Frost's page for another worship session like this. There's big things coming, and we're trusting God for big breakthroughs. All right. God bless you. Have a great day. Bye-bye.